What is going on, ladies and gentlemen? It is Marksman here, and I have your daily dose of Search and Destroy. Wow, it's been a long time since I've done that comment, like intro to the commentary for you guys. This is not a huge gameplay, but what makes it awesome, it is Boost Slam Central, all right? That's what it is. It is Boost Slam Central. I get like 5 slams this game, and I wanted to show you really cool armor that you get for it, which I think I show at the end, which you'll see. And I won't spoil it yet. It'll be in the title probably, but you'll see what it looks like, all right? Anyways, today I wanted to talk about something that I haven't brought up before, but I brought up in the stream, which is kind of link spamming. Like, I know a lot of content creators are out there, and a lot of small ones as well, that are trying to get into it and trying to, like, you know, grow their YouTube, their stream, whatever they're doing. And I wanted to let you know that by going to other people's streams, by other people's YouTubes and spamming your link, all you really get accomplished is people to dislike you for doing that. It doesn't honestly help you that much. Your best bet, honestly, and 100%, this is 100% honest. I'm not trying to skew you guys. I'm not trying to like avoid spam. It's going to happen regardless, I know. But I wanted to help you out if you are a content creator. This is not a way to grow. It's a way to alienate yourself from actual content creators that do, you know, have some success, whether it's a lot or little. And if anything, you're going to look bad in their eyes, and they're not going to want to help you if they ever have the option to. So I know instantly, man. If someone like spams their stuff in the chat, I block them. I block them and I ban them from my chat. That way, I never have to. I know if I go to their stream in the future that I do not want to support that person because they spam. Like I know that. But you're like, old Marksman, if we can't do that, what's the way to get noticed? What's the way to get seen? Like, there's a lot of ways to do it. And I can't tell you there's one obvious, like, this is the one way to do it, because there's a lot of ways. But in my opinion, I think one of the best ways to grow your channel is to work with other content creators. And you don't need to work with big ones. You don't. Like, Wildcat talks about this. You guys might know I Am Wildcat. He does some trolling videos or funny videos. Not really trolling anymore, but more funny videos, funny GTA videos and other stuff. Other funny videos with Vanoss and a few other smaller guys. Well, I would say smaller, but they're Mil Plus channels, you know. Vanoss is the largest. That's why I say him. He's the most well-known in their group. But, like, those guys didn't, like, you know, it wasn't just like, oh, Vanoss has 1 million subscribers, I have, like, 10,000, I'll work with him. It wasn't like that. They did YouTube videos long before then. And that's kind of how I knew Wildcat back then. I was like, when he had, like, 10,000 subscribers, I had, like, 12 or 15,000 or 20,000. And he grew a lot more than I did, obviously. He took the right approach with what he did. And he worked with a small group of friends and made really entertaining content for people. That's the best way to do it. And there's more examples of it. You look at KYR Speedy and his group. You can look at Wildcat Vanoss and that group with Minilad and Nogla. You can look at, I mean, even what Kostov does now with like the Lagoon Squad, whatever. Like, in general, that's the best way to succeed. You could look at CNanners and people he does like Gmod with, which is like Gassy Mexican and Renee and Eat My Diction. Like, in general, that's the best way to grow, is to work within a small group of people and to make entertaining content. Unfortunately, it's hard for me to do that because there's not many YouTubers that do Search and Destroy very often. Tyler, I'm trying to get to do more videos with, but he's never really around to do them. You need to, like, make sure you tell him. If you don't know Tyler, his name is Dysfunction. I stream with him every day. He helped me with my YouTube channel when I was smaller. He's also a YouTuber, does amazing content. You need to check his channel out. I do not know how I didn't kill that guy. I will link his channel in my annotations, and you can also, it'll be linked in the bio. You guys can check him out in there. You should subscribe to him. He does a lot of really entertaining search content, whether it's a funny video of, like, getting trolled by the game, or maybe it's a commentary, or maybe a dual commentary with myself or other content creators that are YouTubers. But in general, there's not a whole lot of us. I would say the main few, this guy gets destroyed. I'm sorry, whatever your name is. I would say Spanksy is one, Dysfunction is one, I Am one, Citizen Nuketown. I mean, there's more. I'm not going to remember everyone. I apologize. This is just off the top of my head. I'm just like thinking and going to it. Candy and Locke kind of post once in a while. Like, these are the people that I play with that I know post Search and Destroy related stuff. And there are a little bit smaller channels than them, too. But in general, it's just not a huge community. I missed that. I fucking was so sad I missed that. But that is the best way to grow on YouTube. It's not to spam links. It's not to spam, or even your stream. It's not to do that. It's to work with a few content creators, form a group, maybe 4 people, 5 people, and make entertaining content with them. And you're like, well, Marksman, how do you do that? The entertaining content is up to you. I can't delegate what you should be doing with your channel. If you want Call of Duty videos, if you want whatever type of videos, Madden, FIFA, in general, I can tell you, though, that comedy is a good way to go. You don't have to troll. Trolling does not mean you need comedy. Comedy can be a lot of different things. But in general, comedy can be the most entertaining way to grow your channel. That's why I like have my dad play the game. He's funny to watch. If you watched yesterday's video, you'll know that. My dad is a hilarious COD player because he has no idea what's going on. But if you want to check out that video, you can totally do that as well. Just check out my recent videos, and I'll actually put it in the description as well if you'd like. My dad plays Call of Duty. There are plenty of episodes of it around there. I think I've done like 5 or 6 with them in total, and it's always funny to watch him play. It really is. So, I'd say the best ways to grow, try to do some things that are comedy or mix them in. Another way is to make sure your content is of decent quality. 720p, it's recorded from a capture card, you're using a decent microphone and decent editing software. That can be difficult, I understand, but that's what people expect. It's 2015 now, we've had HD content since 2009. If you don't have it 6 years later, that you know you can't really expect people to watch shitty content. That's why I apologize for the 480p in my stream stuff, because it's being like, it's downloaded, rendered, like downloaded, uploaded, re-rendered, downloaded, and it's like uploaded again, and that's what ruins the quality. But I apologize for it because people expect good quality, and they should. So those three things can help you out quite a bit, and I would highly suggest that you look into it. But that ends the game right there. We're going to go into the loading screen here in a second, and you're going to see what you unlock for getting, I think, 5 boost slams and 3 boost slams in a match. You get the Jax boots and the Jax shin guards, which look pretty sick. Unfortunately, they only last 30 minutes. Which sucks, but they look sick as hell. I'll let you guys check that out. Thank you for watching the video. I hope you enjoyed. If you liked it, give it a like. If not, it's okay. I'll still love you. And I hope to see you guys again later.